and it goes well with modern Scandinavian design that people want in their houses at the moment. These are good sellers, and I think they're going to continue to increase in value as the years go on. It's a good.
So that was a different lead-in to the video today. Why? Because one, I want to talk about pottery, porcelains. A lot of people are not selling them here in the United States especially, and that's a shame. But it's also a blessing for resellers like myself. So I'm going to talk about some of the items that recently I sold on eBay, as well as give you a little more information about porcelain and pottery to a point. And also, I'm going to interject with some advice about some YouTube channels that you should be watching. I won't tell you exactly what channels to watch because there's so many, but basically I'll tell you what you should be looking for when you search. To give you more information as to what's selling, not just here, but across the pond in the United Kingdom. I sell a lot to the people of the UK, France, Germany, etc. And you could be doing the same too. So let's start out with this piece of Spode Colport. It's a classic design, which is called Blue Willow. It's made of bone china, and it's England, and their parts, their pieces are always well marked, so you will never have to guess, you know, what you have. This is a marking on the bottom, and it tells you exactly what it's made of, the company's name, its place of origin. And this one even tells you that it's the willow design. That part is like a bonus because it doesn't always tell you what the design is. Many times you just, you know, need to know. Or there are plenty of reference books as well as websites where you can get that information. And why it's important is it makes a difference between selling this for $10 or selling it for almost $40 or a little over $35 as I did. This actually went to a location here in the United States, and it was part of a large lot of items which we acquired, and I'm trying to think like how many pieces, and these are all different pieces, so all of them were not Spode Colport. But I'm going to say that we probably in that haul had a little over 100 pieces of different things. Some of them you'll see here, and some of them we have listed for sale, and many of them still need to be listed. So this sold for $36.99, and $7.95 is what it costs for the shipping and handling. And I think we actually paid very, very close to that for the shipping and handling. So for our handling fee, we did not really make anything there except for maybe a dollar or two. And something else I noticed, it seems as if on eBay, the prices for shipping have gone up because items I had previously researched for shipping and added in my handling fee, I noticed that when I'm like purchasing the postage using their new system, that it is very close to the amount that I actually charge the person. And I am comparing, as I always do, to see if I could ship the item faster and still make some money on the shipping and handling. In many cases, I'm able to do that, but I make very, very, very little on the shipping and handling fee that I charge. So something to be aware of is you might have to increase, like, this I have listed for $7.95 for shipping and handling. The previous, that Colport Spode item I had, which was a, I should have told you, a tea. Technically, it's a ginger jar, but, I mean, they don't really use ginger jars anymore, so I think I put it under a tea jar or tea caddy, because in England, the UK, they use them both ways. But anyway, in that case, charging $7.95, and in this case, charging $7.95, my future postage would be like $9.95 for the piece of porcelain that you just saw. And this one, I probably would keep at $7.95 because I have to see. I think I'm going to be shipping this, because this one I haven't shipped yet, but I will be shipping it first class. And I know that that will probably be like $3 or $4 and some change, so I'm good with that. So I'm just saying, be aware of, you know, your shipping and handling fees, because you might have to charge like another dollar or two to cover your supplies, your time, your gas, etc. So this is an antique photo album. All the photos have an impression that shows that the photos were taken in Paris, France. And I can show you that here. And that's actually impressed into each of these photos. I didn't look up the translation, so I don't know what it means, other than obviously Paris is in France. And these are some amazing, photographs. I mean, the detail is pretty good, especially for that era of photography. And these are printed on like a vellum, which I've never had vellum photos before. And, I actually got this with another, I'm going to show you a book. Actually, I'm not going to show you that book. It's not in this bunch. But I purchased a bunch of children's books, and I also purchased a stamp book, some loose stamps, a bunch of die cuts, which were Victorian, and those were in a huge photo album. There were a lot of them, as well as some postcards. I purchased some nature prints, which were like, you know, various plants, flowers, that type of thing. And they were all hand colored, and they were dated in the 1800s as well. And there was something else in that lot. I want to say that there were, oh yeah, there was a little Victorian photo album with tintypes in it. So little photographs on tin. And I purchased that entire lot of items along with this photo album for $30. I did show you guys in some previous videos what a few of those items went for. I know that the post, like the stamps, I had that in one video. I had the die cuts in another video. And I don't think I had anything else in any other video. Oh yeah, I had some of the books, the children's books, in, you know, previous videos as well. So as far as a profit, I mean, we made a huge profit on the $30 that we spent, and this photo album was sold for basically $30, and this is actually being shipped to France, to Paris, France, and it's another one I'm shipping out today, and I'm going to see if I can grab this sheet of paper. And I'm holding this, the camera in my hand today, which is probably stupid because I didn't feel like setting up the tripod and everything. Where is it? Let's see if I can show it to you without showing you the whole thing. So as you can see, it's going to the United Kingdom. That's very blurry. London, England, to be exact. And like I said, I do sell a lot to people in the United Kingdom in total, as well as in France and Germany, etc. So if you're not selling internationally, I really don't know why you're not doing that, because some of the items that you see out there will only sell in those countries. And they are very generous when it comes to paying for your items, as well as paying for the shipping and handling. I've never had an issue. This, if I mailed it in the United States, I would have charged $7.95, but internationally, it actually came to $22 and some change, which the buyer paid. So, you know, I would definitely, you know, look at do, and I used to use a global shipping, but I found that people didn't like the fact that, you know, the item had to be shipped to some place in the United States and then it was shipped out from there. So it was like delaying the delivery. So I'm just showing you some of the words that are on these pictures. And that's just a beautiful picture of a lady with some children. And I don't remember how many pictures were in this album, but there were a lot. So, the other lesson is, which I've talked about before, bundle your buttocks off. This is a Howard Miller Westminster Chime mantle clock, and it's made of brass. The thing is, which I sort of hate this, but, you know, it's battery operated, so you have to put a battery in it. And I really just don't like battery operated clocks. I know, you know, technology, move on, etc. But, you know, I do sell clocks, especially locally or through private sales. And most of them are the antique clocks that do not require a battery. So, you know, clocks that require batteries do sell. You just have to know which ones sell and the many, many, many that do not sell at all. Simply because they're very common, they're easy to make. You know, they're just not, I hate to say it, special enough. They're functional, which there's nothing wrong with that. So if you need a clock, even if you want one that's stylish, if it requires a battery, there are millions of them out there. But, there are a select few that actually sell decently, as this one did for $32.99 plus $11.95 for shipping and handling. And I was able to ship this out for about $7 and some change, almost $8. So, you know, there's a little bit, you know, of money to be made there as far as handling goes. Next, you know, as I was talking about the porcelain or bone china, the other area that people have tended to stand back from is selling pottery. Pottery still sells. It depends on what it is. It depends on how old it is. You know, the design of it, you know, people are looking for. I find right now they seem to be looking for more the arts and craft era. So not arts and crafts that your kid created in their art class, but there was an era just like Art Nouveau, Art Deco, mid-century modern, Grecian, you know, I could go on and on. There was a brutalist period at one point. You know, all these different eras. There was an era that was named arts and crafts. And so things of that era and pottery are still selling for decent money. You just have to make sure, just like with anything that I've showed you, that you pay very little to nothing for the items. I will tell you, I told you about the ephemeral lot that I had, which included the French photo album, but I will tell you what I paid for all of the rest of the items at the end of this video. So this, I noted as an antique primitive quart crock blue flower decorated stoneware, and I got it here in New England, so obviously I noted it as a New England find. It was an almost absolutely perfect condition. You could tell by the bottom that it had been used, but there was no damage whatsoever. And so I sold it for almost $40 plus $8.50 shipping and handling. Thank goodness this was only going one state over from where I live. And therefore, actually, why does it say that is, oh, it says ships too, because this actually went to New York, and because of that, it was just slightly under $8. It was like $7, whatever, I'll just say 90 cents. To ship this. So on the shipping and handling, obviously not very much money made there at all. Once again, if I had known that the shipping rates had changed via eBay, or I don't think they changed with the post office, I think it's some sort of eBay thing, I would have listed this with a postage of at least $9.95 or $11.95, something like that. But I was able to send it priority mail too. So it came, yeah. So, you know, whatever. The person is going to get it really fast. And one of the things that I do when I sell is I try to, like, for example, if someone pays, like in this case, this person paid $12.95 for shipping and handling. What I do is I compare the shipping rates. And as long as I make a few dollars, you know, $2 to $3 on the shipping and handling, obviously if I make more, even better, I'm happy with that because that covers the time that it will take for this item to be, you know, wrapped up, packaged up so that it can be shipped out, as well as the supplies. So I'm good with that. So what I will do is I will try to ship the item quicker than what the buyer will expect. In this case, it says economy shipping, and I think that's like the parcel select. However, this I was able to print out a priority mail label for, and the shipping on this actually came to, I believe it was like $8. Just slightly, I would even say like just very, very close, slightly over, under $8 to ship this. So that way the person will receive this in just like 2 days, 3 days, and versus the, I think it's like 6 to 9 days if you use parcel select. So that way you're exceeding their expectations. And of course they don't expect that. So, you know, that's just something you could do to increase your customer service satisfaction. If you care about feedback, which I should do a video on feedback and the reasons why I really don't care about feedback, you know, that would be something that would definitely, you know, help boost that for you. Plus, to me, it's just really good customer service, you know, to exceed someone's expectations. So that's a better angle for this. So this is a vintage Romer, Italy, hand-carved wood fisherman smoking pipe and shoe. The reason that I listed this one, or put it here, I should say, because of course I listed it, is because the description is what sold this. This person collects things that deal with tobacco, pipe smoking. So when it came to pipes and fishing, which happened to be a dual interest for this individual, this item obviously had everything. So when you describe your items, you know, some people are telling you the shorter titles are better. That is so not true. I would say having an accurate title is better, and making sure that the words you use in your title are relevant. Like, that's what you should be concerned with. There's a reason why you have so many spaces that you can use to put text in. The other thing I would say is do not use symbols. Do not use, you know, 14 exclamation marks. There are people who write the word look, which are type the word look in their listing title, which makes it look really desperate. And notice I used a double entendre there because I said look again. You know, all of those things are irrelevant to coming up in a Google or an eBay or, you know, a Bing or whatever search engine you're using. The thing you want to use are just actual words, and make sure they're relevant to whatever it is you're listing. People who are shortening their listings are missing out on having keywords show up in their search engine. So the person found this because they put in smoking pipe. That's why they found it. And look at how, like, there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, like 7 or 8 words that come up before the word smoking even shows, let alone the word pipe. So, you know, I recommend not shortening your titles, just making sure they're relevant and they do not include unnecessary words and symbols. So this, as I noted, sold for $32.99 plus $12.95 shipping and handling, which I stated it was barely $8. So this is one that, you know, I'm satisfied with what, you know, little profit I made on the shipping and handling. So I have one more item to show you. And I have to talk about this item before I show it to you. The reason why is, you know, my husband and I commonly talk about the fact that, you know, we are thankful, blessed, gift, you know, the gift of the gods. You know, they are constantly looking down on us and, you know, we're just very fortunate and very thankful. But we also appreciate what we do as, you know, I'm calling us the real American pickers. Because unlike the television show, you know, we do what they used to do, which is not overpay for any item, or if we can get items for free, you know, that's what we do. Otherwise, there's no way you're making a profit unless the television show, you know, network, I should say, is paying you a paycheck, which supplements everything you do, as well as it supersedes any money you probably would have made on your own, because, you know, if you're getting paid $30,000, $40,000, $50,000 per episode, then, you know, you can afford to overpay for the things that are going to help you have a television show. So, you know, we're always, we just sit there and wonder, like, we're just like in a state of wonder when we're like, we can't believe the things that are going into landfills. You know, hundreds of millions of dollars in merchandise that people actually want, they collect, they've been looking for decades, which is the case in the item I'm going to show you. And we are fortunate enough to sometimes recover those items before our workers take a shovel and technically throw it down a chute that's been set up from a second or third floor window, attic, wherever it was, to go directly into a dumpster. Thankfully, I do recovery to make sure that does not happen. So without any further ado, here is the item which we just sold. And this has been delivered, and we received incredibly positive feedback. It's called, it's from the 1950s, and it is a tin wind-up Jimmy the Clown toy by a toy company named Flair, which was located in Japan. It came with the original box, and this dude, meaning Jimmy the Clown, I mean, he was almost in absolute perfect condition. And you can see the original price written on in pencil on the box. I think you could see that, 79 cents. Crazy. It's a Flair toy. And this, I literally snatched this out of a pile that one of our workers was going to toss into the dumpster, only because I noticed, of course it was in the box, but I just happened to notice the box, and he's like, yeah, it's just like a cheap toy, excuse me, not real, and I always do the recovery. Our workers simply are there to like throw things away, lift heavy things, etc. That's all they do. Which is a lot. I mean, we couldn't survive without them, so I'm very thankful and blessed that these people work with us. But you can see, like, the staples. Like, this is so old that back then the boxes were stapled. which nowadays for kids' toys, they would not staple them because fear of choking. But this toy sold for $309 even. It had 11 bids on it. And the shipping, yes, I charged $7.95. And the actual shipping, I think, came to like $5 and something. But what I did is I insured it. So because it was insured, the $7.95 was almost complete. I think it even went over. It may have gone been like $8.22, something like that. But it just shows you that, you know, there are definitely crazy treasures out there that no one wants. And when they say they just want everything to go, like literally they just want it to go and be gone, go to a landfill, get recycled. They don't care what happens to it. And also if you're working with people through your business, like we have people that we contract out to or that contact us to work with them, you know, you really need to look at everything because this would have been $309 that would have been crushed in a recycling situation or simply thrown in a landfill in one of our gigantic dumpsters large enough to hold a giant SUV plus still have room left. So I'm just saying that because I'm just telling you this little tiny thing, there's no way it would have been recovered if I just did not happen to see it. So, just like the previous video I did with the vase that we sold for over $600, that was another item that we almost threw in the glass pile because we actually have a company that will buy glass by the pound. And so you really need to just look. There are treasures out there there are things out there that are obvious, such as if you saw this at a flea market, you would probably buy it, obviously, if the person didn't know what they had. And, you know, we were happy that we were able to get this to someone that had been looking for it for decades. So I'm going to do another video that will go into the porcelain world vibe and also give us a thumbs up. You know, please leave some feedback down below as far as, you know, just tell me, like, have you ever found anything crazy that you barely paid anything for or that was on its way to the garbage and came to find out that it was worth, you know, over a couple hundred dollars? Let me, you know, tell us about that. Tell us what it was. And thank you for tuning in. And I will be back with more videos on reselling and some more tips and tricks.